line.
Hello, is anyone in the studio?
Is it Griffin? I think it's, is it Griffin?
It might be.
Well, I thought it was maybe, Daniel Harris.
Huh. Oh, hey, Daniel.
That was loud.
Oh, yeah.
There you are, Daniel.
I'll turn you down a little bit.
Thank you.
Yeah. All right, Daniel, you can send it up to us, whatever you want.
Do you want purple or blue?
I like the way this one writes.
I like blue. Hello and welcome to another Asbury University basketball broadcast. Tonight, we have the conference tournament, Andy. Asbury Eagles versus Berea Mountaineers. And it is going to be a great game tonight. Well, we can't wait to bring it to you. Asbury ranked number 3 in the conference. Berea, the number 6 seed coming into the tournament. And we've actually had the other tournament games today already take place. Knockout tournament. Andy, how about you tell us about some of those
results? Yeah, Asbury and Berea is the last matchup of the first round of the KIAC men's basketball tournament. Earlier today, the number 1 seed Indiana Southeast defeated Alice Lloyd by a count of 9, 77-68. So a close game there, actually.
Yeah,
I'm kind of surprised at that.
A lot of surprising results.
Cincinnati Christian won the 4-5 matchup against Point Park, 87-70. And then Indiana East, the 2 seed, squeaked by Brescia, 69-68. And so if Asbury wins tonight, they will face IU East in the next round.
Squeak by being the key word there. Indiana East, a very good team, and now Asbury will play them. So
if
win, go through.
Yeah. First things first, though.
Yeah, gotta take care of business tonight. And Berea Mountaineers, as we've seen in the past, a very good team.
Yes, they've given Asbury trouble this year, Josh. They have a record of 15-15. They're 7-8 in conference, but two of those wins have come against Asbury, as Berea has swept the season series. But as my coach always told me in high school, it's always hard to beat a team 3 times in one season.
Yeah.
Hopefully that adage holds true here, and Asbury will be able to make it through the second round of the tournament.
Yep, hopefully third time will be the charm for Asbury tonight.
That's right.
I got to call the game at home against Berea. Last second 3 that beat us at home here. Crazy game. And a lot of fans out here tonight. Hopefully tonight will be another exciting game, but more exciting for our
Asbury.
And
I believe,
Eagles.
Was that 3 hit by Ponder? Aaron Ponder?
Aaron Ponder.
That's the guy Asbury has to shut down today.
Aaron Ponder, Andy and I were talking about him before, just fills up the stat sheet in a lot of categories.
He's the most important player for this Berea team, as he's averaging 12. He's a leading scorer of 12 points a game. He's also averaging over 4.5 assists per game. An incredible number there. He's also hit 74 three-pointers.
Yeah, he
and
is.
And so Aaron Ponder is the guy Asbury must shut down.
He is wearing number 5 for Berea tonight. Starting lineups for both teams as we get ready to tip off. Adam Delph starting for the Eagles. He is number 10. Levon Morris, number 11. C.J. Penny, number 25. Dakota Oob, number 33. And Justin Jones, number 34. Austin Flannery is sitting out tonight. Unfortunately, he will not be available for the Eagles. And starting for the Berea Mountaineers, we have our man, Aaron Ponder, number 5. Number 14, Dominique Garden. Number 23, Seth Beckham. And number 47, Webster. And number 44, Cody Riley. Webster and Jones will tip off here as the refs actually go get a ball from behind the stands here.
And, Josh, this Berea team, it's kind of youth versus experience. Berea starting 4 sophomores and a freshman.
Very young.
Asbury starting a team with a lot of experience in Jones, Delph, Morris, Uhen, and Penny, even though Penny just started playing this semester for Asbury. But experience versus youth here. We're about to get underway.
and Jones wins the tip-off. That is tipped to Levon Morris. Eagles will start the game with the possession. Eagles going from our left to right and from our right to left. The Mountaineers will go. They are wearing blue. Eagles wearing their white with purple trim. Dakota Uten with an early three from the right side, and that one is good.
That's important for Asbury. Get Uten going here. He's a great outside shooter.
Uten, a big man, but he has a nice stroke from outside. Oh, now almost stolen away by C.J. Penny on the other end. And that is Seth Beckham with the ball now. He finds Ponder, the big player for the Mountaineers here. Delph will guard him. That will be an interesting matchup to see throughout the night. Now Riley swings it around to Ponder. Now into the post to Tevin Webster. And Tevin Webster can score, and he does. Nice little hook shot there.
Yeah, he got good position there on Uten. Just put the hook shot over Uten. Got it to go.
And now Levon Morris crossing over to his left. Hands off to Delph now. Left side from three. He fakes it. Now inside to C.J. Penny. A nice post move there and a nice little J.
Asbury needs to ride Penny tonight. If they're going to put Ponder on him, Penny's got a good size advantage, so post him up.
Yeah, it looks like a switch matchup there. Allowed C.J. Penny to get inside. Now swung over to Dominique Garmin, right corner. He'll bring it back out. Now Ponder out near half court. Near
Josh,
the Eagle.
Asbury is opening up in man-to-man defense.
Yes, yes. Very tough man-to-man defense. Now Ponder has it, swings it to Beckham. Beckham trying to find a pass inside. Nice defense there, and poked away by Levon Morris. Justin Jones comes up with it. Now Morris pushing the other way. Crosses over to his left and pulls a long three off the pitch from Dakota Uten, and that one is good.
Asbury clicking on all cylinders early on here.
Levon Morris struggled the past two games shooting from range. I got to call both those games, and he opens up with an early three here. Oh, and now Webster gets the ball inside. He was in the paint, and it looks like he was fouled. Looks like a little bit of a tit-for-tat foul there.
Yeah, I guess referee establishing his presence early on.
Eagles up 8-2 here, 18:03 left on the clock. That was Dakota Uden's first foul, first of the night for either team.
And Josh, I think tonight will be important to fan support, as it's not filled to capacity, but seems like a festive atmosphere in here.
And with those festivities, Justin Jones gets a little shout-out from the crowd there as he gets a block. Eagles come the other way, and Adam Delph hits a three from the right side. Eagles up 11-2, 17:53 left on the clock.
And the Berea coach is going to take a 30-second timeout here as Asbury is coming out. I don't think we missed a field goal yet.
We have not. Asbury now 4-for-4 from the field, and more importantly, 3-for-3 from behind the three-point line.
That's right, Josh. clicking on all cylinders. The guys are ready to play tonight. It's early on, but definitely want to start out a game like we are right now.
Yeah, fast and furious action. Hard to keep up with it all here. Adam Delph with a three, Levon Morris with a three, and Dakota Uten with a three. Eagles look like they want to come out and establish their rhythm, which is quick at the beginning
That's
of the game.
That's right. Will Schaus' team likes to run down, shoot a lot of threes. Asbury's going to want this game to be a high-scoring affair.
Yeah. And when the Asbury Eagles hit threes, that's when they can win games, and they're doing it early here. Aaron Ponder will now handle for the Berea Mountaineers, top of the key. He finds Garmin open right side. He drives in after a nice pump fake. Poked back out, though. Now Adam Delph comes up with the ball. Nice hustle by him. And now, top of the key, that's Levon Morris. He finds Delph now right side. Delph looking for a pass, calling out for his teammates to get open. Now dribbling to his left, Ponder guarding him. An interesting matchup tonight for both of them. Now in the post to C.J. Penny, and a nice fadeaway jumper off the backboard.
Very nice, using the glass there. I thought Penny kind of faded away there when he had a much smaller defender on him, but he got it to go off the glass.
C.J. Penny, a very athletic offensive presence. He's averaging 15 points in this second half of the season after he was ineligible the first half of the season. And now that one is poked out by C.J. Penny. Another athletic play. He poked out the pass of Aaron Ponder. It'll be Berea Mountaineers ball.
Yeah, very intense defense here by Asbury. Playing with a lot of passion, tenacity. And you can see the bench as well. The bench is really showing support for the team, getting up, clapping, everything.
Yeah, getting up and clapping after every good play that the Eagles make. Now Garmin gets it right corner for three, and that one is good. Dominique Garmin with the three.
I believe he said his foot was on the line there, Josh.
Oh, it'll be a long two. looked like he was clear in the corner, but you got to get those toes behind the line.
That's right.
That'll make it 13-4, 16:45 left on the clock as Levon Morris brings it over the halfway line.
Berea's showing 2-3 zone here.
Yeah, switching to the zone early. Eagles have exploited that three. They'll hope to look to do that here.
Yeah, not sure what the coach is doing here. Asbury's been 3-3 from behind the arc going to the zone.
Now Uten gets open, top of the key for three, and just like we said, he hits a three early.
That's 2 threes for Uten on the night. He's got 6 points.
Uten having an outstanding night, and just like that, the other way, Aaron Ponder crossing over, gets a nice little long two there. 16-6, 16:13 left on the clock in this first half. Now Morris, another long three after the pick from Jones. He misses this one badly, though. Aaron Ponder gets the rebound, and the Mountaineers are coming the other way.
Nice transition defense there by Asbury.
Oh, and Adam Delph almost got a poke away from behind of Seth Beckham there. It'll go back to the Mountaineers, though. Ponder will set up the offense. Now Beckham drives inside. He goes in on Jones. That's a tough matchup. He misses it. Gets his own rebound, though. Goes back up with it. And they're going to call a travel on Seth Beckham. Eagles with some great defense.
Yeah, good defense there by Asbury. Not exactly sure what Beckham was doing there. He's listed at 6'1", going against the 6'7" Justin Jones there. Jones will win that more often than not.
Yeah, Jones, a very tall and athletic defender. Subs for the Mountaineers, that's number 20, Rashad Hayden, number 31, Trent Maddox, and, oh, my fault, number 30, Trent Maddox, and number 34, Deion Banks. Eagles swing it outside now, that's C.J. Penny. And looks like they'll call a push-off on one of the Mountaineers there.
Well, they got that on Maddox.
Yeah, Maddox, who just checked in.
Although he doesn't start, Maddox is an important player for Berea. I saw his name in some of the leader categories for conference statistics.
Yeah, a lot of these Mountaineers players get on the stat sheets in different ways, and they actually, as we mentioned earlier, lead the NAIA Division II in assists. Now Uten gets it left side. He's hit those 2 threes early. Now he gets it into C.J. Penny. Free throw line jumper, no good. And it is tipped out of bounds. This will be off of the Eagles, though. Mountaineers ball.
Look, good shot there by Penny from the elbow.
Yeah.
Just rimmed out.
He got open.
We'll take that.
Uten drew the presence outside, and then Penny was able to free himself up at the free throw line. Uten looking very good early on. Mountaineers have it now. 16-6, 14:57 left on the clock. And they get it to Maddox, left corner for three, no good. Justin Jones with the rebound now, he gets it to Levon Morris. Eagles push it over halfway now. Levon Morris gets the pick from Justin Jones coming to his right. Now he slashes inside, ooh, he had the open layup but couldn't convert.
Couldn't get that. Nice drive there, tried to finish with the left hand, just missed it short.
Oh, and Ponder with a long three early in the shot clock, no good, and a nice strong rebound by Levon Morris.
Ponder shot that one from the water tower.
That was a long, long three. Morris finds C.J. Penny in the post now. He's guarded by Maddox. I think he'll exploit that matchup, and he does. Long fadeaway jumper again. Missed this time by C.J. Penny.
Quick Penny's settling there. He doesn't need to fade away. He's got the size advantage.
Back to Maddox now. He finds Webster inside in the lane, and he'll be fouled by C.J. Penny and go to the line for two. And C.J. kind of forced to make the foul there. They found a nice cut inside to Webster.
Yeah, nice look there.
Webster went up with it. Webster, a good player for this Berea Mountaineers team. He gets about 8 rebounds per game. He'll go to the line for two here. That was CJ's first, second of the night for the Eagles. Mountaineers have a foul as well. Webster makes that one. Seth Beckham checks back in for the Mountaineers for Aaron Ponder. And Mitch McLeish, number 20, checks in for number 34, Justin Jones. Webster will go to the line for a second here, trying to make it an 8-point lead for the Eagles. He makes that one 16-8. Asbury Eagles up, 14:05 left on the clock, and the Mountaineers are doing a full court press here.
Easily broken there by Asbury.
Yeah, way to get it across. Some good passing. Just got it across quickly to Levon Morris. Now Uten has it near half court. He gets it to McLeish left side. McLeish with a long three, no good, and that's rebounded by Deion Banks. Seth Beckham coming the other way for the Mountaineers now. He's got it at the free throw stripe. Kicks it back out to Deion Banks. He's wide open inside, and he gets the layup to go.
Breeze on a little run here. They cut the lead to 6. Asbury's missed a few shots. Just need to get some defensive stops.
Yeah, Eagles have to shut them down on defense. 16-10 here, 13:23 left on the clock. Penny gets it in the post, now swung around. Mitch McLeish gets it, drives inside, and misses the layup. Deion Banks with another rebound. Maddox will get it for the Mountaineers. And he finds Rashad Hayden left side. Now they swing it around to Beckham, back to Hayden. Now in the post to Deion Banks. He's been doing well early, and he gets this hook shot to go.
Yeah, Breen's having a pretty good go of it down low. Just not great interior defense.
Oh, but a great interior pass by Levon Morris there. He found Mitch McLeish inside of his hand, and McLeish makes that too. 18-12, 12:44 left on the clock. Eagles up. Now Beckham, top of the key. He's guarded by McLeish. Now passed off, but nobody switched over to him, and Beckham makes the open two. Long range two there. That'll make it 18-14, 12:29 left on the clock. Delph comes around a screen by McLeish to the right side. Penny has it now right side. He's looking for a pass. Finds Uten, top of the key. Dribbles to his left and hands off to Delph. Fakes the long three. Now drives in. Kicked back out to McLeish, top of the key. 15 left on the shot clock. Back to Delph, top of the key for three, and that is a long three, and it is good.
Delph's second three of the night, shooting well from the outside.
Yeah, two long threes for Delph early on here. Tevin Webster coming the other way. A long hook shot there, no good, and rebounded now. Eagles pushing the other way. Levon Morris drives into the paint, throws up a wild shot, no good. Great offensive rebound by Mitch McLeish, and he will go to the line for two.
And that foul was on, they got that on Maddox. That's his second.
And that'll be the second team foul for the Berea Mountaineers. 21-14, Eagles up here. There'll be subs after this foul shot for both teams, four for the Mountaineers and two for the Eagles, as McLeish goes to the line for his first. Ooh, misses it long. And here's the subs for both teams. Number 33, Tyler Huff for the Mountaineers, as well as number 5, Aaron Ponder checking back in. Number 44, Cody Riley. And I did not see who the other sub was. Oh, it was number 14, Dominique Garman. And two subs for the Eagles. Sean Bronner getting his first time of the night, and Justin Jones, number 34. Sean Bronner having two solid games the past time
I've seen him play. Yeah, against IU Southeast, he played a great game running the point.
Yeah, he had 10 points and 4 assists in that game, and he's gotten consistently better this season. Let's see if he can control the tempo here. Now Cody Riley gets it near the free throw strike, backs down on Justin Jones, now kicked out. That is number 33, Tyler Huff. He gives it back to Riley. Long two there, taking over Dakota Uten. Not going to make that one with Uten in your face, and he doesn't. Sean Bronner has the ball now. Bronner going around the screen from Uten. Finds McLeish inside, and a nice spin move by McLeish.
Nice move there by McLeish. Spin move. Got him the baseline there. Just laid it in off the glass.
And that makes it a 10-point lead for the Eagles, 24-14. Ooh, Berea Mountaineers almost pass it out of bounds, but Dominique Garman hangs on. Now he kicks it back to Beckham, left side. He's crossing over, drives inside in the paint. Nice free throw line, step back. That one is no good. He gets his own rebound again, though, and throws it out to Aaron Ponder. Mountaineers get a new shot clock to work with. 10:40 left on the game clock here. Beckham has it now. Oh, and he pulls. A nice screen there, but Beckham misses another offensive rebound, this time by Cody Riley.
Yeah, these long rebounds, Berea is able to get them.
And the shot clock was not reset after that second missed free throw. Missed shot, my fault. CJ Penny checking back in for the Eagles for Dakota Uten. And Eagles not doing well to box out their men. Cody Riley with two offensive rebounds.
Yeah, yeah. Sometimes, you know, playing defense and there's a shot from the outside, there's going to be a long rebound. And sometimes offense is just in better position to get it.
Number 2, Bryce Carlson, checking in for the Berea Mountaineers. That is his first action of the night as well. I saw Carlson in the last game play, though. He's a hard worker, and he can shoot from the outside as well. Riley has it now. He finds Ponder, top of the key. He mishandles it, kicks it off his own leg. Oh, and now the ball's on the floor, and it's tipped off of the Asbury Eagles. I thought maybe that tipped off Ponder again, but CJ Penny and Adam Delph diving on the floor.
Yeah. Ponder tried to go between the legs there and kind of hit it off his knee and ran back to get it, but Delph just like hustled there, dove on the floor, almost got it for Asbury.
Yeah, almost caused that turnover. Tevin Webster checks back in for the Mountaineers on that dead ball. Mountaineers have it now. That's left corner. Dominique Garmin, no good, and rebounded by Mitch McLeish. Poked away, though, by Bryce Carlton. I told you he would be active, and he is early. He gets it back inside to Garmin. Oh, and Justin Jones goes up, but it's going to be called a goaltend. Nice block there, though.
That was a great block there by Justin Jones, but I think he got it on the way down. He pinned it against the backboard. Fantastic block, but... I mean, that'll be on the highlight reel, but unfortunately, it's also goaltending.
Mountaineers full court press again. Mitch McLeish beats Bryce Carlton down the floor, though. Now he throws it inside to Justin Jones. Kicked out to Sean Bronner. No good from three, and that one will go off of Berea Mountaineers. The Berea fans do not like that. They're right behind.
Yeah, nice hustle
them.
There by Jones. The long rebound there. Huff thought he was going to get it easily. But Jones came over there and forced him to go out of bounds off of her.
Yeah, great hustle by the Eagles so far. Adam Delph throws it in to Mitch McLeish, top of the key. Eagles will run their offense here. Now swung over to Delph, right side. Around the horn to Sean Bronner, left side.
Berea in 2-3 here.
Another 2-3. Adam Delph, left corner, three. That one is no good. But C.J. Penny comes up with the rebound. That was a long rebound. Unlucky for the Mountaineers. And the nice pass by Sean Bronner.
Bronner with a no-look pass there. I tell you what, he's got some handles.
Sean Bronner, one of the best ball handlers on the team. Didn't get a lot of time earlier in the season, but his minutes have picked up, and it's easy to see why. Dominique Garmin threw his shoulder into Bronner there and got an easy two, and Bronner went flying. Nothing called. Eagles pushing the other way now. And Mitch McLeish and one on the fast
break
opportunity.
Found it, baby.
Oh, my goodness. Mitch McLeish was found with a nice pass.
Nice body control by McLeish, too. The defender fouled him, and while he's in midair, able to adjust and get the shot up off the glass.
Berea with two subs. That's Deion Banks checking back on, and number 30, Trent Maddox as well.
Yeah, Maddox playing with two fouls here.
And Mitch McLeish got a full court pass. That was great awareness by the Eagles to beat them down the floor. It wasn't even a fast break. It was off the scored basket by the Mountaineers, and Mitch McLeish makes it count with an and one.
Yeah, he's got 8 points on the night.
29-18, 9 minutes left in this first half. Eagles up here. Now it's found to Rashad Hayden. He'll swing it, top the key to Deion Banks. Banks takes a step inside, then takes the two, no good. And Justin Jones with a strong rebound. Now Sean Bronner coming the other way for the Eagles. Hands off to McLeish, right side three. Great looking stroke, no good though. Poked back out, and Seth Beckham comes up with it. Mountaineers are going coast to coast. Oh, and Beckham will be called for not a charge because it's a block on Adam Delph. I thought Delph did good to get back in transition.
Coach Schaus cannot believe that call, nor can much of the Asbury student section.
Adam Delph looked like he was in good position. Might have had a foot inside of the regulation area there.
He maybe his ankle was touching it, the back heel of his foot maybe. I don't know, but Coach Schaus beside himself when he saw the ref. Call that a blocking foul.
Levon Morris checking back in after that blocking foul. That's three fouls for both teams. 29-18, 8:25 left on the clock as Hayden has it. Top of the key here. He gets it inside to Tevin Webster, posting up on Justin Jones. Nice inside move, and Jones will be called for the foul, and Webster gets it to go.
Yeah, not bad defense there by Jones, I didn't think. Webster kind of just got lower than him.
Yeah.
Not much of a foul there, I didn't think, but...
That is Jones's first...
I'm biased.
14 foul for the Eagles. Aren't we all here for the Eagles? Webster misses his free throw, though. Justin Jones, as you said, nice defense there, standing his man up. Webster just got that inside step and went underneath him. Now Bronner has it. He gets it to Jones, top of the key. Pump fake now inside. Drives on Webster, doesn't get it to go. Now it's tangled up, but no jump ball called. Seth Beckham comes up with it after that little tangle. Oh, and he gets a nice pass to Maddox. That's missed, and Tevin Webster, one-hand putback.
Yeah, Maddox shot his layup too strong. Webster there, just easy tip in.
Eagles again get it a full-court pass to Sean Bronner, but he pulls it back out. Adam Delph has it now, swings it to Penny. Left side from three, fakes it. Now nice little pull-up, Jay. No good, and Tevin Webster comes up with another rebound. He's been active. Oh, Mountaineers push, going, trying to go coast to coast again. Deion Banks inside misses it, and C.J. Penny comes up with the rebound.
Yeah, Asbury's transition defense hasn't been great the last few times there. Berea should have scored there.
Oh, and Adam Delf running right into Rashad Hayden. Hayden just gave him a little bump there, and Adam Delf goes flying. It'll be a foul on the floor. Adam Delf will take it out of bounds underneath Asbury's basket. Subs for the Mountaineers. Aaron Ponder coming on. He checks in for Trent Maddox. And for the Eagles, Mitch McLeish and Dakota Uden, both of whom have been having great nights.
Yeah. McLeish, I believe, has got 6 points on that. I said eight earlier. Delf is the one with 8 points. But McLeish providing a spark off the bench for Asbury.
Yes, and Uden with those 6 points. He's 2 for 2 from the field and 2 for 2 from the three-point line. Levon Morris will take it out near the sideline, near our commentator's box. I say box, but it's really just a table. Morris inbound. Oh, and it's tipped away by Garmin, but Mitch McLeish with some nice hustle.
Great play there,
back away.
Great play there by McLeish.
McLeish has been so active this half. He's been hustling around, and he has the ball now at the top of the key. He looks for a pass, finds Penny, top of the key to Delf, left side. Now swung around to Levon Morris. He finds McLeish now in the post to Penny, but Aaron Ponder reached in trying to get the ball from Penny.
Yeah, McLeish tried to get down low to Penny. Ponder anticipated the pass, tried to get the steal. Just kind of went through Penny to do it. So that's his first foul.
And now inbounded by Adam Delf. They get it inside to Penny early. That one is missed, though, by Penny. Penny, after having a good start, has missed a few here. Now Garmin going the other way and blocked by Adam Delf. The pass, I believe it was a pass, was intended for Deion Banks, and Adam Delf went up athletically, knocked it out of bounds off a Mountaineers player. It'll be Asbury.
Yeah, McLeish did a good job keeping. Who was that for Berea there?
That was Dominique Garmin.
Garmin, yeah. McLeish did a good job there keeping Garmin in front of him, and that allowed Delf to kind of come up over top of McLeish, get the deflection. And the ball went out of bounds off of Garmin.
And as we've seen, Adam Delf, just a very, very good shot blocker, rebounder. He does it all for the Eagles. Eagles up 29-22 as the ball is swung out to Mitch McLeish. He's open for two, and that one is good from the top of the key.
Nice pass there by Penny as the defense was sagging down on him, found McLeish on the wing.
Oh, and now Seth Beckham the other way. A nice little drop step there on Mitch McLeish and got the layup to go easily. 31-24, 6:12 left on the clock. Eagles up here. Berea has had a nice comeback after going down 13-2 early on.
And Berea is showing again 2-3 zone.
Eagles have been able to exploit that. They've hit some long threes, and they've got a capable three-shooting lineup on the floor now.
I look at Uden here.
Uden now gets it inside to Penny. 12 left on the shot clock. Back out.
There we go, baby. Money! Money, baby! Dakota Uden.
Dakota Uden again. He got the pass inside to Penny. Penny kicked it right back out, and Uden will nail that one. 3 for 3 from three. Now Cody Riley inside on Uden, and he gets the layup to go. Uden feeling good, though, after that long three. That makes it 34-26, 5:27 left on the clock. Levon Morris has it for the Eagles now. He gets a screen from Penny, top of the key. He finds Delf left side, now in the post to Penny. He posts up on Garmin, and he should make that, doesn't. Dakota Uden with a nice putback, though.
Dakota,
he's everywhere.
He's playing great.
Dakota Uden, one of the most versatile offensive players I've seen in a while for these Eagles, and he is doing it all tonight. He's already in the double digits, 11 points. Coming the other way, Ponder with a nice fadeaway.
That was nice. Fading away to his left.
Yeah, Ponder on Mitch McLeish, one of the better defenders for the Eagles. Now Mitch McLeish going back at him in the post, and he is fouled by Aaron Ponder. Mitch McLeish doesn't let that, he doesn't want that to get away from him again. Yeah.
And that's important because that's Ponder's second foul.
Ponder.
He's the go-to guy for Berea, so maybe we can get a third on him before the end of the half. That'd be nice.
Mitch McLeish goes to the line for two here. There will be subs after the foul shot. Aaron Ponder, as you mentioned, a great player for the Mountaineers. He averages 15 points a game for them. Mitch McLeish makes the first and subs for both teams. That's Huff, Hayden, and Deion Banks coming back on for the Mountaineers, as well as for the Eagles. And number two, Bryce Carlton. Sorry, left him out. Bryce, good guy, good player. And a sub for the Eagles, number 34, Justin Jones. He checks on.
McLeish has got 12 on the night for Asbury.
McLeish and Uten in double digits early. McLeish makes that one count as well. That makes it 38-28 Eagles. 4:40 left in this first half. And there will be a foul called. The ball was passed to Seth Beckham coming around a screen. And it looks like McLeish bumped him or grabbed him.
I think, yeah, a little hold of his jersey there.
Mitch McLeish, a very tenacious defender. That'll be his first foul, 15th foul for the Eagles tonight. And Bryce Carlton will inbound from underneath the Mountaineers' basket. He'll find Beckham, right side. Beckham drives on McLeish now, can't find anything. Back out to him now. He's on McLeish again, driving to his left, now in the paint. Gets inside of Dakota Uden and Mitch McLeish and gets it to go.
Nice drive.
Seth Beckham showing that he's got some ball handling skills as well. Some nice going to the basket. Oh, and Levon Morse the other way misses the spinning layup, but Dakota Uden again with a putback. Now Seth Beckham drives inside. Oh, looks like a travel there, but it'll be called a foul. Seth Beckham slipped his foot.
Yeah, he did a jump stop there, and I guess the floor might have been a little wet there. I don't know. His feet just kind of came out from under him.
Yes.
And got bailed out there, so they called a foul on Jones.
Yeah, and unlucky for Jones. That's his second already. 16 foul for the Eagles. And Beckham will go to the line for two here. That first one is up, and it is good. CJ Penny will check on for Justin Jones, as well as number 00, Daquan Gordon, getting his first action of the night, coming on for Mitch McLeish. DQ, a very good defender, very athletic.
Very athletic.
And a senior as well.
He won't score a whole lot of points, but he'll get you a lot of rebounds, a lot of hustle plays, some blocks.
And he has a fantastic fade.
Yes.
Beckham misses that second one, and Adam Delph gets the rebound. 40-31, 4:02 left on the clock. Delph with a nice crossover. Had to pick up his dribble, but he finds the pass inside to Dakota Uden, and Uden is on fire.
Great, great find there by Delph, as Uden just kind of lost his defender there. And he's got 15.
Oh, with C.J. Penny with a block on Deion Banks. Banks thought he was free for a wide-open dunk, and Penny from the weak side with a LeBron block.
The student section loved that there.
Coming the other way, Adam Delph loses his handles on the ball, and it'll go out of bounds. Mountaineers ball. Mountaineers check in three players, Aaron Ponder, Tevin Webster, and number 30, Trent Maddox, all checking back on. Mountaineers need to stop the bleeding here.
I tell you what, Asbury's playing with some confidence tonight.
Yeah, it looks like a lot of swagger out on the court tonight for the Eagles. C.J. Penny with that block on the previous possession. Oh, and looks like a walk there by Trent Maddox. Nothing called. Aaron Ponder gets the ball, misses a three, and now it's swung around to Bryce Carlton. He'll get it back to Maddox. Now back to Carlton. Left corner three, and that one is good. I told you he could shoot, and he makes it count.
A little bit unlucky there as Bria got away with a walk on that possession.
Yeah, Coach Schaus not happy about that one. Everyone on Asbury's bench a little upset about that travel not called. 42-34 now. C.J. Penny gets the ball left corner for the Eagles. 2:58 left on the clock. And he'll find Levon Morris top the key. He's guarded by Carlton. Now inside to Daquan Gordon, and DQ misses the wide open two.
Yeah, his defender fell down there, and he had a pretty easy shot, just couldn't get it to go.
And Carlton has it now. He's guarded by DQ. That's a little bit of a mismatch. He comes around. He finds Trent Maddox right side for three. No good. And Uden with a nice rebound. Now Delph gets it to Levon Morris coming over the halfway line.
Bria's falling back into their 2-3 zone. Extending it a little bit here. They need to be careful knowing where Uden is.
Now Levon Morris has it. He swings it to Delph. Left side three. That is no good. And DQ comes up with the offensive rebound. He finds Uden the other side of the post. Now back out to Delph, left side three, and that one's no good.
Yeah, good rebound there by DQ. Hopefully, I wish Asbury could have capitalized on that second chance there. Delph had an open look there, just couldn't get it to go.
Sub for the Mountaineers, that's Dominique Garman checking on, as well as Tyler Huff. Now Aaron Ponder brings it over the halfway stripe. He finds Garman. Top of the key. Now over to Maddox. Delph almost got in there for the steal. Maddox drives inside, gets it to Webster. Open for two. No good. Back to Maddox, now out right side to Ponder. Long three, fade away, and that one is good. DQ could not keep up with Ponder.
Great, that was a great shot there. Step back. Yeah. I mean, there's nothing you could do with that.
Yeah, DQ and Ponder matched up on both ends here. Now Levon has it, top the key. Morris crossing over, looking for something. Drives to his right now, gets inside. Nice layup, no good. DQ with another offensive rebound. He can't get it to go, but it's poked back out to Delph. He gets it to Morris. Right side three. That one is no good again. CJ Penny with an offensive rebound. He can't get it to go. Misses, and it'll go out of bounds. And it went off the shot clock. So it will be out of bounds, but the Eagles think it was deflected.
Yeah, it was tipped. The shot was missed, and the rebound was tipped. It hit the shot clock. They say it, last player to touch it was an Asbury player.
Subs for both teams. Seth Beckham checking on, and Mitch McLeese checking back on for the Eagles.
Yeah, Asbury getting a lot of second chance opportunities here. They're just not able to convert.
They have to convert those. DQ, the possession before last, had one, and then CJ Penny had two opportunities there. Ponder has it now. He brings it over halfway. He's looking for a pass. Finds it to Garmin, right side. Now Tevin Webster, top of the key. Swings it around to Ponder, left side three. No good. Tipped out by Tyler Huff. And it'll be a fresh shot clock for the Mountaineers. 42-37. 50 seconds left on the clock. 30 on the shot clock now as Ponder sets up the play for the Mountaineers. Now Garmin has it, top of the key. Swung to Ponder, left side. No good from three. And Uten with the rebound. Levon Morris has it now, and he'll call out the play for the Eagles as he brings it slowly over the halfway line. 33 seconds left on the game clock, 25 left on the shot clock. McLeish gets it now. Now Uten, top the key. He gives it to Delph, mishandles it, but he gets it to Penny in the post now. He posts on Tevin Webster. Ooh, nice spin move, backed it back out,
good
and he gets
there.
It to go.
Penny working hard there to get that basket. Increases the lead to 7.
44-37, 10 seconds left. On the clock, shot clock is off as Ponder has it top the key. He looks for a screen now. 5 seconds left on the clock. Hands off to Beckham. 3 left on the clock. He drives inside. Gets it to Huff. Open. Open jumper. No good, though. And that'll be the half. Eagles up 44-37. And it has been a fast and furious first half.
It's been a great game. I've enjoyed watching it. It's been great. Dakota Uten, Mitch McLeish. Really playing well. Uten especially, he's got 15 points here for Asbury in the first half to lead all scorers. McLeish contributing 12. Delph also playing well. He's got 8 points. Asbury really started off the game fantastic. I believe he got started out on a 12-2 run.
Yeah, 13-2 run.
13-2 run there.
Eagles, very, very high-scoring team, and it looks like it's going to be a high-scoring game, and this one could come down to the wire. Eagles got up early, but Mountaineers have fought back well.
Yes, they have. Great tenacity there by Berea, persistence. As, like you said, Asbury started out really well, got a double-digit lead, but Berea never really came within distance of taking over the lead.
Yeah.
But they're still within, 7 points. Anything could happen.
And
a little bit too close for comfort right now.
Yeah.
But Asbury, played really well in the first half. And you want to go over some stats here?
Some of the stats that jump out to me, points in the paint tied for both teams. I knew Berea Mountaineers had a strong presence inside with Tevin Webster, but Webster hasn't had quite the impact he usually does. Only 2 rebounds from him so far.
Yeah, he does have 8 points, but only 2 rebounds. That's key.
And as well as the bench scoring for the Eagles, 12 points from the bench and 7 for the Mountaineers. And anything jumping out to you?
Well, both teams shooting pretty well from the floor. I mean, Berea's shooting 44%, Asbury shooting 43.5%, so about, we're basically even there.
Yeah.
Asbury 6-14 from behind the arc for 43%. That's been really key for the Eagles in the first half. Berea not shooting that well from behind the arc, only 2 of 9. Neither team went to the line a whole lot. Rebounding battle, Asbury is winning 24-19, 15 with 15 defensive boards for Asbury, 9 offensive boards. And, turnovers. Both teams have played well in protecting the ball, as Asbury's only got two turnovers, Berea three.
Both, so, yeah, both teams very good assist to turnover ratio. Eagles are number 19 in Division II NAIA with only 1.1 per game, and the Berea Mountaineers have even better than that. Their assist to turnover ratio 1.3. They're number 4 in NAIA in Division II.
Yeah, Berea takes care of the ball. A lot of their baskets are scored off of assists. But yeah, Asbury came out with a lot of heart there. They've lost to Berea twice this year. They do not want this to be the last game of the season, and they want to continue on. And they came out really pumped up.
Yeah.
And hopefully that continues on in the second half, as the, in my opinion, the first part of the second, first 5 minutes of the second half are the most important minutes of the basketball game. So.
Yeah, and last game, an absolute heartbreaker against Berea here at home, 69-66, a last-second three, and I mean, just a crazy game to call. I got to call that one, and Eagles definitely didn't want that to repeat itself again. With that, though, it's 44-37, Eagles up now. We'll see if they can stick this game out. And just a reminder to those of you listening on WACW and IHI, this is a conference tournament game. The winner of this game will go on and play IU East, who won earlier today. And
the loser will go home.
The loser goes home, as is customary.
And also, for you listeners out there, the Lady Eagles are continuing their season, as they defeated Brescia earlier tonight by about 15 points. So
very, very up-tempo game. Eagles won 95-80.
Yeah, so Lady Eagles move on to the next round. I'm not sure if their next game will be at home or away. Depends on how the other teams did in the tournament. But hopefully we can make it a sweep here tonight, doubleheader sweep.
Good luck to the Women's Eagles on their next game, and we'll see if the guys can join them in the conference semifinals. For Josh Brown, this is Andy Clark.
We'll send it back to the studio. Have a second half action here in about 10 minutes. I believe Daniel Harris is in the studio. Daniel, take it away.
And for you watching on iHi, the video feed will still be up, but we will take a little break and bring it right back. Thanks. Asbury Eagles basketball action. Asbury up at the break, 44-37, and we are ready to get the second half kicked off.
Yeah, this is a special tournament edition of Eagles basketball as we're taking on the Berea Mountaineers. Up by 7 here at halftime. Asbury really came out firing on all cylinders as I believe we hit our first 4 or 5 shots, and like 3 of those were from behind the arc. And Dakota Uden, very big first half.
Dakota Uden, 15 points in the first half.
Did he miss a shot?
I don't think he did. Because
he is 6 of 6.
Ladies and gentlemen, Dakota Uden is having what may be a career night for him by the time this is over. He made 3 threes, missed none of those, and then a lot of putbacks and a lot of good moves in the post.
He's come up really big. And McLeish off the bench, Delph, Penny's had some nice shots down there. But Berea's still hanging around, only down by 7. They're definitely capable of coming back and stealing this one from Asbury. Hopefully that doesn't happen. But as we begin to start the second half here, still about 40 seconds on the clock. Berea's already got their players out on the court.
They are excited to get back out and going.
Looks like the same starting 5 for Berea.
And it might be good to mention that both of these teams like to score a lot of points. Berea might score a lot more in this half. They might come out more up-tempo than they did. Asbury averaging 78 points per game, and Berea just a clip under 83 points per game.
One thing I think will be interesting to see, we didn't see hardly any full-court pressure from either side. Berea showed it a few times, but not consistently, just one or two times. So it'll be interesting to see if either team will show some full-court pressure.
And Berea will inbound now. The same starting lineups for both teams that we're on. If you are watching on iHi.com, Berea, the blue team, going from our left to right. That is the commentators left to right. And Asbury in the white going right to left. They're wearing white with the purple trim. Some nice purple Asbury color.
Looks nice. Yeah.
Now Adam Delph has it after the ball goes out of bounds off a Mountaineer. Eagles get possession of it. C.J. Penny now top of the key. Hands off to Delph. He takes the early 3, and that one is
money.
Good.
Money, baby. That's right. 47-37. Adam Delph.
Adam Delph showing the swagger early in this half.
Came to play.
Ponder has it now. Now Beckham, left side 3. That's a nice-looking shot. No good, though. Adam Delph with the rebound, and he's been all over the stat sheet. Now Delph goes coast-to-coast and finds a pass to Justin Jones, and Justin Jones is wide open for the layup.
Nice drive there by Delph.
Delph got past Ponder after the rebound, just drove inside, forced the big man over to help on him, and that left Justin Jones wide open. Now Ponder, top of the key. He finds Garmin. Nice pump fake. Now gets it out to Riley. That is missed, though, and C.J. Penny comes up after a few tips. He gets the rebound. Eagles looking strong early here. 49-37, 18:50 left in the second half. Adam Delph has it now. He finds Penny top the key. Fake handoff to Delph. Now Penny pulls a long 2. Ooh, and that one is airballed. Penny with kind of an ill-advised shot there. Now Beckham coming coast to coast. Blocked by Justin Jones, though. He said, not in my house.
Yeah, Asbury's all-time leader in blocks.
And he just keeps getting better and better over 200. Oh, and C.J. Penny coming the other way. Wide open. The Mountaineers look bamboozled.
And nice word there, Josh. And Jones with the assist. Nice pass there from the center.
Jones.
The two big men feeding each other.
Jones was at the top of the key, and I don't know what happened to the Mountaineers. They didn't have any post presence, and C.J. Penny was wide open backside.
Again, the beginning of each half, Asbury has played fantastic. Berea, this is almost like, except our points have come down low this half. Delph, with the exception of Delph's 3, this is almost a mirror image of what happened the first half. Berea's taking a timeout here, and we haven't even played 2 minutes yet.
And, I mean, just the tempo that Asbury came out with, and the lack of focus by the Mountaineers is surprising. 2 of those plays were just finding a man open after having to help over.
Yeah, and just we're sitting next to the Berea bench. It was a pretty passionate huddle there. As they realize if they keep playing the way they are, their season's going to be over. They're down 14 now. And so trying to light a fire over there to get them going.
Yeah, Coach John Hemingway trying to right things at the helm for the Berea Mountaineers here. Ponder will bring it over the halfway line. 18-14 left on the clock. Self got a little lost, but Ponder passes it off now. Beckham inside just got free for the layup, and that one's good. Levon Morris gets it now. He comes over halfway for the Eagles. He calls out the play, gets the play from Coach Schaus.
Berea showing 3-2 zone, excuse me.
A little 3-2 zone look here. Adam Delph now has it. He finds Penny in the post, kicked out to Uten, left corner. Now swung around the horn, and that is Jones. He gets it to C.J. Penny. Now back over to Delph, left corner. 10 seconds left on the shot clock, but he finds C.J. Penny for the alley-oop. Yep. Not a dunk, but a layup.
Berea's really focusing on Uten there when they're in that zone. They just lost Penny, and Penny got the shot to go.
And coming the other way, the Mountaineers get an early two in the shot clock. Eagles just not picking up correctly.
Yeah, Webster hit that right inside the arc. I'd say Asbury would be okay with that with their power forward shooting that 18-footer.
Yeah, usually Webster not known for his outside shooting. More of a get it in the post and work on his man. Poked out of bounds off the Mountaineers. It'll be Eagles' ball in the left corner. Levon Morris has it now. Morris left side looking for a pass. 53-41. 17 minutes left on the clock. Now Morris gets it to Delph. Delph inside to Uten. He posts up on Deion Banks, and that's a nice fadeaway jumper.
7-for-7. Uten had great position there. He had deep position in the post. They fed him, and easy shot there.
Yeah,
easy shot allowed by the position he had.
He's got some great post moves, and he gets position well. Oh, and Deion Banks coming the other way in the post. Gets fouled by Justin Jones. That'll be Jones' third, and Banks will go to the line for the and one.
I believe they called that one on Uten there. I think they lobbed it over Jones, and they called it on Uten, the help defender there.
Yeah, that's good news for the Eagles. Uten with his second foul. First of the half for either team. Jones has two fouls as well. Now Banks will go to the line for the 3 points the old-fashioned way. He does not get the 3 points the old-fashioned way, though. Misses. Uten with the rebound. Oh, and now Berea with some full-court pressure. Eagles get it across. Delph beats the trap. And now he finds Uten open for three right side. Oh, and that one with the shooter's bounce in. Dakota Uten, 8-for-8.
It's his day.
He is 4-for-4 from behind the three-point line. And when things are going well, that ball will roll in, and it does. Now Ponder from three left side. No good. That one rolls out. Deion Banks offensive rebound. But Justin Jones with some nice pressure. He might have gotten a touch on it from behind. Now Delph has it. Goes around the screen from Penny. Pulls the three with a man right in his face. Missed. C.J. Penny taps it around, though, and it'll go out of bounds off Aaron Ponder.
Good
Eagles ball.
Good work there by Penny, crashing the offensive board. He and Ponder fighting for it, and the taller Penny able to knock it out of bounds off of Ponder.
Oh, and Levon Morris passes it inside to Delph. They try that inbound pass they always like to play. That play they always like. Now Uten is found open again from three. He's open, and it's good. He's 5-for-5, ladies and gentlemen.
Uten, 9-for-9 from the floor. 9-for-9.
5 three-pointers. He has not missed a three-pointer, and Dakota Uten is on fire.
He's unconscious, Josh. He is unconscious.
61-43, 15:45 left on the clock. Eagles are up in large part due to Dakota Uten. He's got 23 now. And now inside the other way, the Mountaineers get a foul, and they'll go to the line for two. Oh, my. Enough cannot be said of Dakota Uten tonight.
They call that foul on Morris Frasberry, his first team, second of the half.
Eagles have to make sure they don't get into foul trouble early here. Banks will go to the line for two. Bryce Carlton set to check in for the Mountaineers. He will come in for Seth Beckham. Banks makes his first. That makes it 61-44. Eagles with a great start to this first second half.
Yeah, great start to both halves for the Eagles.
And Banks makes his second at the line. Banks a big man. Nice stroke from the line, though. Now Penny will handle for the Eagles. Penny with some good ball handling for a big man. He finds Morris now, top of the key. He gets the screen from Uten, goes around, drives inside. Kick out to Justin Jones along two. That one's no good. And off of Berea again, it'll be Eagles ball. Justin Jones doesn't take twos from that far away usually.
He usually doesn't shoot it from the outside, but he was so open there, he had to take it.
Now Delf inside to CJ Penny, and Penny with the shooter's bounce as well. Nice little mid-range little floater and there, and good, that one will go.
And good recognition there by Delf, seeing that Penny was open on the inbounds.
Now Banks again working in the post on Jones' right side. That one is missed, and Trent Maddox trying to get the offensive rebound goes off his hands. It'll be Eagles ball again. 63-45, 15:07 left the clock as the Mountaineers, I thought they were going to pick up full court, but they'll drop back into half court man-to-man now. And Levon Morris brings it across for the Eagles. He calls out the play. They'll find Jones now, right side, looking for a pass. Penny, top of the key. He finds Uten, right side, long three, and he makes another one!
Oh my goodness, this is amazing. This is one of the greatest performances I've ever seen, Josh.
Dakota Uten!
And his teammates are swarming him here, as he's 10 of 10 from the floor, 6 of 6 from behind the arc.
This is one of the greatest performances I've ever called. It is. It is the greatest performance I've seen on the floor from any player that I have called. And, Andy, the Eagles are running away with this one.
Yeah. I'm from Maysville, Kentucky, and we had a really good shooter by the name of Chris Lofton from there. Went on to score over 2,000 points at Tennessee. This is like a Chris Lofton
yes.
performance here. He just cannot miss, Josh. He can't miss. I would think Berea would have they here in this timeout, they have got to have a guy that's just going to face guard him the whole time. He's got, I believe, 26 points.
Yeah, 26 now.
And we still have over 14 minutes left in the game.
And it is, that makes it a 21-point lead for the Eagles, 66-45, 14:43 left on the clock, as you said. And they're just riding the back of Dakota Uten there. You saw Coach Schaus call out the play for Levon Morris, and I didn't figure right away that would be a Dakota Uten play, but the way he's been shooting, they drew it up for him. It was the same play as their last trip down the floor, and Dakota Uten makes them pay again.
Yes. Uten. All the teams contributing here. I mean, Penny's played well here in the second half, but we can't let our foot off the gas pedal here. We're up by 66-45, but there's still a lot of time left, over 14 and a half minutes left.
Also of note for Uten, 8 rebounds. He's only 2 shy of a double-double, complementing that 26 points already. Mountaineers will inbound from their sideline. Seth Beckham, top of the key. He drives in on Levon Morris. Oh, but it looks like a block from behind. It'll be called a foul here. Looks like on Levon Morris.
We got that on Morris. I think the refs could have had a couple of Asbury players there. They could have called that one on.
Yeah, 3 Asbury players, Morris, Delf, and one of the post players, Jones or Uten, all came over and took a shot at him. Beckham will go to the line for 2. He misses the first.
Rims out.
Unlucky there for Beckham.
Berea only 5 of 9 from the foul line.
And free throw shooting does make a difference in conference games like this if it does come down to the wire. Beckham to the line for a second here. A check-in for the Mountaineers. I'm not sure if it was after the free throws. That free throw is missed by Seth Beckham. Rashad Hayden checking in for the Mountaineers. And Tyler Huff as well. Oh, and Tevin Webster poked that ball away. He gets the steal from CJ Penny. Dominique Garmin pushing the pace. He'll go coast-to-coast, but miss the layup. Webster with an offensive rebound. He can't get it to go. Justin Jones with some nice box out there. And now Levon Morris has it for the Eagles. He comes over halfway, guarded by Beckham. He gets the screen from Jones coming around to his right. He gives it to Uten right side. This time doesn't shoot. Now gives it to Jones, top of the key. 20 left on the shot clock. Uten gets it inside to Penny. A mismatch inside on Garmin. It'll be called off of C.J. Penny. You can tell the fans don't agree.
Yeah,
with
the
that
fans
one.
Don't agree. Levon Morris and C.J. Penny don't agree. They try to get. They asked one of the officials to overrule the call there, but they're going to keep the original call. Berea ball.
And now coming over halfway is Seth Beckham. Eagles still up 66-45, 13:43 left on the clock. Huff swings it to Hayden. He comes around a screen by Beckham. Now inside to Garmin. Back out to Huff, right side. No good. Offensive rebound by Garmin, and he's fouled by C.J. Penny coming down.
Nice move there by Garmin. He got that rebound. I realized he was kind of in amongst the trees there as he's giving a few inches there to Penny. He utilized the shot fake, as Bob Knight would say.
Yep.
He loves the shot fake. So he got the defender up in the air, leaned into him, headed to the line for 2 shots.
Yeah, C.J. Penny, athletic play there, was coming down and tried to get the block. Garmin makes his first. Ponder checking on for the Mountaineers, and Mitch McLeish coming back on for the Eagles. His first action of the half after having a strong first half. Garmin will go to the line for his second. That one is up. Oh, and it rims in. That one went a good few feet off the rim. Now inbounded to McLeish. 66-47, 13:28 left on the clock as the Eagles are up here. McLeish comes over half court. He finds Uten open. He pump fakes, though. Nice pump fake. Now passes it off. It's inside to Delph, left side in the post, working on Ponder. Nice post move. Now finds Jones open inside, and that's a great pass by Adam Delph.
Adam Delph with the look. I thought he was going to shoot it there, but he saw that Jones was open. Jones with the reverse layup.
Now Beckham working on McLeish, right side. He finds Garmin, swung around the horn to Huff, left corner. Now coming to his right, hands off to Beckham. Nice screen by Huff. Beckham open for two. No good. Rebound by Tevin Webster. Kicked out to Ponder, top of the key. And he'll bring it back off, back out, and slow things down for the Berea Mountaineers. Ponder coming around a screen, now crossing back over to his left. Gets it to Huff inside. A lot of contact, nothing called. And Adam Delph comes up with the steal. Four players for the Eagles in double digits. Delph, McLeish, Penny, and Uten. Delph coming the other way. Nice floater over Webster. Doesn't get it to go.
I thought that was down.
And Huff coming the other way for the Mountaineers. Coast to coast. Nice pass to Seth Beckham, and that's an easy two. Eagles, I think, all expected that one to go down as well. McLeish has it now. He'll come over the halfway line. Gets the play from Schaus. Looking for a pass, finds Jones top of the key. Now he gets it in the post to Penny, matched up on Ponder, and a nice post move by Penny.
Yeah, Penny with the size advantage on Ponder there. Ponder tried to go for the steal. Penny did not allow that to happen, laid it up and in.
Oh, and Ponder around the back, fadeaway jumper, no good. Rebounded by Mitch McLeish. Eagles looking strong here.
Berea's going to fall back into their zone defense here.
And a timeout called by Coach Schaus here. 70-49, 11:39 left on the clock, and the Eagles have continued to have this lead.
Yeah, they maintained the lead here. Delph playing really well as he's getting his own buckets, but also finding his teammates in positions where they can succeed. As he found Jones there with a nice pass in the easy lay-in.
Adam Delph almost having a double-double himself, but not with rebounds. 9 assists on the night for him.
He's dealing the dimes.
Adam Delph handing out the open shots, and Dakota Uden has been hitting the open shots as well as the contested shots this half. And I just need to go back to the stat. 10 for 10 from the field, 6 for 6 from the three-point line, and just an absolutely monstrous night. He's got 9 rebounds now and 1 shy of the double-double.
Yeah, that's right. And I think if I'm Berea, I think you got to start showing some full-court pressure. I mean, it's a little early, maybe a little early for that, but you're down by 21 points with a little bit over 11 and a half minutes left. But you got to get something going here.
Yes, Eagles very strong. As I mentioned before, their average for the season is 78 points. Only 8 points away from that right now, Andy.
I think it's a safe assumption that unless Asbury just goes insanely cold. I mean, the rate we're going now, we'll get that here in a few minutes. But, yeah, Asbury's been playing really well. Brea's not played badly. But
just a tough game.
Yeah, and they haven't shot the ball as well here in the second half.
Sean Bronner checks on for Asbury, as well as subs for the Berea Mountaineers. Trent Maddox and Bryce Carlton.
Berea showing their 2-3 zone here.
Bronner top the key, has to pick up his dribble. He finds Morris, now swung around, open. Mitch McLeish left corner, should have pulled that one. Now he finds Uten open, right corner, pump fake, out to Bronner, top of the key for three, and that one is good. Sean Bronner, the senior.
I thought Uten was going to take that shot, but he made the extra pass to a teammate who was even more open than he was.
Bronner decided he wanted to dish out an assist instead of getting all the points himself.
Bronner wants in on the action there, so.
Berea Mountaineers now the other way, 73-49, about 10:53 left on the clock. Tevin Webster found open mid-range jumper, and that one is good from the left side. Eagles just got lost on that one. Webster was open on the backside, and he was open for two.
Yeah, Webster having a nice game. He's got 12 points.
Webster, a good rebounder as well. Only has 4 tonight. Eagles beat the full court press. And Levon Morris, nice up fake and gets it to go the other way, coast to coast.
And something, Bronner was trapped in the corner and he got out of it by throwing a behind the back pass.
Bronner, just a great ball handler, great passer. And Ponder throws up a wild three. That one is missed. Eagles get the rebound and they are fouled on the rebound.
Yeah, the Eagles have stretched the lead out to 24 here.
75-51. 10:30 left on the clock now. That was Deion Banks on the foul. First of the half for the Mountaineers. Eagles have 14 fouls. Bronner now. Oh, tries to find the alley-oop to Justin Jones. Too much traffic in there, but he'll be fouled and go to the line for two. Sean Bronner with some great passes as soon as he's coming.
Yeah, Bronner shook his defender there with a crossover. Got past Ponder, I believe it was. When the defense slid over, threw it up for Jones.
Jones just couldn't corral that one to dunk it in. Now,
headed to the line, though.
Yeah, going the line for two here. Tevin Webster on the foul. That's his first of the game and second of the half for the Mountaineers. Subs for the Mountaineers, number 44, Cody Riley, and number 23, Seth Beckham. Jones to the line for his second. Trying to make this lead even further stretched out for the Asbury Eagles. That one is up. Good rotation, and that one falls in. 77-51, and it'll be an off-the-ball foul called here on Sean Bronner. Just a really strange call. Sean Bronner didn't really know what happened on that one.
Yeah, Bronner ended up on the deck. I think he was trying to get an easy, a sneaky steal there.
And a foul call. That is his first, fifth of the half for the Eagles. Bryce Carlton and Sean both laughing about that one. Kind of a weird play. Just got tripped up. Carlton coming the other way now. Hands off to Beckham. He finds Webster right side. Now back to Carlton, top of the key. He hands off to Maddox. Great defense by Sean Bronner, though. Now in the post to Cody Riley. Justin Jones in his grill, but Cody Riley, a great putback.
He somehow got that to go.
Yeah, a great little layup there.
Good defense there by Asbury.
Mitch McLeish beats the full court press, full court man-to-man by Seth Beckham. He gets it over to Levon Morris now, right side. He goes around the screen from Jones, finds McLeish left side. McLeish now in the post to Jones, and he's wide open for the dunk!
Throw it down, big fella! Throw it down!
And the fans are on their feet! Justin Jones was mismatched first on Bryce Carlton, got inside of him. Oh, and he converts the dunk like Hakeem Olajuwon.
Hakeem the dream.
And the other way, Trent Maddox hits the three from the left side for the Mountaineers, still fighting to stay in this game. 79-56. Oh, and Bronner with a nice pass. Bronner cut inside.
That was
nice crossover, and then a no-look, little nonchalant pass behind him to Justin Jones.
I think Jones was a little surprised by that pass there.
Jones didn't. No one saw Bronner about to do that one. He didn't see it. No-look pass.
Sean Bronner's a smooth operator, I tell you.
And Justin Jones to line for two. And that was a foul on number 30, Trent Maddox, my fault. That is his third of the night. Justin Jones makes the free throw count. Subs for the Eagles. Adam Delph and C.J. Penny, and subs for the Mountaineers. Number 14, Dominique Garmin, and for the first time, number 3, Ryan Schnellenberger.
Schnellenberger. He's from
Shepherdsville, Kentucky.
Yeah, I wonder if he's related to the former Louisville football coach, Howard Schnellenberger.
We may have to ask him after the game.
We'll have an exclusive interview.
Oh, and Jones makes both of the free throws, and then Levon Morris with some full-court pressure. The only guy down there almost got the steal.
Almost got it.
It'll go out of bounds. Now Eagles going with what looks like a 2-2-1 look on the zone. Full court press here. And Adam Delph pokes it away. Stolen here. C.J. Penny gets it. Back to Delph. Back to Penny. Great passing. And that's an easy layup for Penny.
The intensity is fantastic here by Asbury.
And now trying to get the full court pressure again. Levon Morris with the reach in from behind. That's the sixth foul for the Eagles. Third of the night for Levon Morris. And Berea Mountaineers will inbound from the sideline closest to the fans. 83-56, 9 minutes left on the clock as Seth Beckham drives inside, and he'll go to the line for two. Looks like a foul on Levon Morris again.
That's his fourth.
And Coach Schouse gets Mitch McLeish up off the bench to come in for Levon Morris. Beckham to the line for two here.
Yeah, two quick fouls there for Morris.
The first one trying to reach in from behind and poke the ball away. And this one just trying to stand up. Seth Beckham forced the contact, Becca makes the first as Mitch McLeish checks on for Levon Morris, and he'll go to line for second. For those of you watching on iHigh.com or listening through WACW, we hope you stick with us the entire way. A conference matchup here between Berea and Asbury as Seth Beckham makes his second free throw for Berea.
Here's the full court pressure for Berea.
Berea with the full court pressure. Mitch McLeish gets it over to Justin Jones. Justin Jones gets it across half court, and he'll be fouled.
Yeah. Jones did well there. I mean, he's a power forward, so he's not used to handling the ball. But he did well there, dribbling across half court amidst pressure.
Yeah, some good full court pressure by Berea. Good passing by the Eagles to get across, though. Sean Bronner now top of the key. Onus poked away off his pass, but now Mitch McLeish fires a bullet into C.J. Penny, and he will lay it up and in.
Nice look there by McLeish.
And that makes it 85-58.
We have an illegal screen here.
Oh, that is the first time I think I've seen an illegal screen in all my time calling a game here at Asbury. They do not call those often. It'll go against number 44, Cody Riley, and that'll be the fifth foul for the Berea Mountaineers.
And Josh, I was just looking at our stat sheet. 25 assists for Asbury.
Eagles dishing it out. Sean Bronner finds Adam Delph open from the top of the key. He misses that one, though.
Almost 26 assists. Asbury sharing the ball. Well,
And Seth Beckham coming the other way. Mitch McLeish in his face, but makes the three, trying to fight back for these Berea Mountaineers. That makes it 85-61. 8 minutes left on the clock as Delph gets the screen from Jones. He kicks it out to Sean Bronner, top of the key. Now around, back to Delph, in the post to Jones. He'll post up on Cody Riley. Now C.J. Penny at the free throw stripe. Drives inside, looking for a pass. Oh, and finds the cutting Mitch McLeish for a layup. That's just a great play.
Yeah, that was a fantastic pass by Penny. That's probably the best assist we've had all night, and we've had a lot of good ones.
We've had a lot of good ones. 87-61 here. Oh, and a foul called on the Eagles. Not sure what happened. Looks like a bump, and the ball went out of bounds. The Eagles all thought it was just regular old play.
Out of bounds, but they called McLeish maybe on a hand check.
Yeah, McLeish's second, eighth of the half for the Eagles. Tevin Webster checks back in for Berea Mountaineers as Seth Beckham goes to the line again. This one up, and that one is good. And that puts the Berea Mountaineers in the bonus, by the way. Seth Beckham to the line for his second end of the 1-1. Seth Beckham having a good night tonight. He's the leading scorer for the Mountaineers. He has 16.
Make it 17.
After that, made a free throw. Seth Beckham, a good producer for this team. He also has 5 rebounds, having a good all-around night for the Mountaineers. Mountaineers do not full-court press this time, and Sean Bronner finds a full-court pass to Adam Delph. A little too much on that one, though. It goes out of bounds.
Yeah, good idea. I mean, trying to make something out, not a whole lot there, but good idea. If it would have worked, it would have been fantastic. But
a good look, but just too far for Delph. Now coming around, that is number 4. That is his first check-in, Lathan Bennett. He checked in after the foul shots. Oh, and now a block for the Eagles, but thrown away by C.J. Penny after they got the turnover. Oh, and a pull early here on the shot clock for number 3, Schnellenberger. That one is missed, but it's tipped off an Asbury player and out of bounds for the Berea Mountaineers.
Yeah, C.J. Penny had a great block there. And he tried to do a little bit too much there, throwing the home run ball down to Bronner.
Lathan Bennett to inbound to Schnellenberger. Now top of the key is Garmin. Garmin on Delph. Crosses over to his right, finds Deion Banks. Now in the post to Schnellenberger. He gets it out to Garmin, almost mishandled. He gets it, though. Now Banks at the free throw line, no good. Oh, and Justin Jones, a strong rebound. And he gets it to Delph. Eagles will slow it down here with 6:45 left on the clock. 87-63 as Sean Bronner brings it across half court. Bronner finds Jones right side. Jones now to Penny, top of the key. He finds McLeish right side. McLeish with the pass to Delph. 15 seconds left on the shot clock. Delph top of the key. Now Penny back to Delph. 10 seconds left on the shot clock as it swung around to Bronner. In the post to Jones with 5 left on the shot clock. He goes up. kicking it to go, but it's tipped out of bounds off of Sean and Bronner. It'll be Berea Mountaineers ball. And the big score for the Eagles, number 33, Dakota Uden, checking back on, as well as number 5, Aaron Ponder for the Berea Mountaineers. Uden got pulled out about midway through.
Gave him a breather.
The half.
He's been working hard. So, and with a comfortable lead, you can do that.
Now Tevin Webster has it for the Mountaineers. Swings it. Top of the key to Ponder. Handed off to Beckham. Still near the top of the key. Gets the pick from Tevin Webster coming around the right side. Kicks it back to Webster. Eagles playing some nice D here. 15 left on the shot clock as Webster pulls it. Left side, nice jumper.
He's hit a lot of outside shots. I've been kind of surprised because he's a banger down low, but he's shown some nice touch.
Sean Bronner brings it across half court now. Gets a screen from C.J. Penny coming right. He's matched up on Webster. Bronner coming inside. Blocked, but C.J. Penny gets the rebound, and he'll go to the line for two.
Yeah, Penny with a nice board, and they call that foul on
Aaron Ponder. That's his third and sixth of the night of the half for the Berea Mountaineers. Ponder got into foul trouble a little early in the first half. Now Penny to the line, 4-2. And that one is up. Oh, and it's missed just short. Penny not the best free throw shooter. He shoots about 50% from the line.
Yeah, he struggles from line a little bit. Hopefully, if he shoots about 50%, he's due to make this one. Yeah. So.
Let's see if he holds true to his average here. He'll go the line for his second here as he relaxes and takes his free throw. Oh, and that one just misses. Averages didn't hold true there. Aaron Ponder gets the rebound. 87-65. Berea Mountaineers down by 22 here. Oh, and C.J. Penny pokes the pass away, intended for Lathan Bennett. Bennett comes up with it, though. He's got it right side. Finds Huff, who checked in. Now to Beckham coming around. He pulls the long range two. Mitch McLeish in his face, though, and Sean Bronner comes down with the rebound.
Yeah, that was a difficult shot. Nice defense there by McLeish.
McLeish did not let him see the basket, and he was all over him on the shot. Sean Bronner has it now for the Eagles. Passes to Penny. Penny, top of the key. Finds Mitch McLeish cutting again. Inside and one. Mitch McLeish is too strong.
I tell you what, Penny's, I don't know how, we'll have to see the stats here. He's got, how many assists does he have? He's been dealing them lately.
Wait.
7 assists. He's got 7 assists on the night.
C.J. Penny and Adam Delph having a great passing night.
Delph with the double-double.
Delph reaches the double-double. 10 assists, 11 points. A lot of Eagles players just filling up the stat box today. And Mitch McLeish will go the line for two. He's having a good night as well. 14 points, 3 assists, and 4 rebounds himself. A great night for a lot of Eagles. And we just broke the 90 mark. 90-65. 4:55 left on the clock as Bryce Carlton brings it across for the Berea Mountaineers. Tyler Huff checking on for the Berea Mountaineers during that break. Now Ponder finds Carlton. Carlton, oh, a pass inside, but C.J. Penny easily picks that one off. Eagles coming the other way. Back to Penny and an easy layup on the full court break.
Yeah, as Penny gave it to Delph. Delph gave it right back to him. He had the easy layup.
And Carlton has it now for the Berea Mountaineers. He finds Huff open left side. Now handed off to Beckham, getting the double team. Now Mitch McLeish on him. Beckham drives inside, finds Bryce Carlton. Oh, nice pass inside to Huff, and Huff with a nice left-hander. That one's good inside. 92-67, 4 minutes left on the clock, and the Eagles have really, really put this one out of reach.
That's right.
You wouldn't think the Mountaineers would come back from this one. It would take a great, great miracle. Eagles, hope I don't jinx it, but Eagles look to hold on here as they just pass the ball around now. 3:45 left on the clock, 13 left on the shot clock as Bronner gets it right side.
Yeah, Berea's here sitting back in a 2-3.
Oh, and Bronner finds the great pass inside to Delph. It's missed, but C.J. Penny almost threw down a rebound. Dunk. Hook back.
Just missed it. Shot. Tried to throw it down with the left hand, couldn't get it to go, but that would have brought the house down.
Great athleticism. Ponder misses a long three for the Mountaineers, and that kind of just, you could see the Mountaineers deflate with that one. 3:13 left on the clock, 23 on the shot clock as Uten gets it for the Eagles here. Uten finds Bronner near half court now, guarded by Carlson. 15 left on the shot clock. Sean Bronner takes on Carlson, now passes out to Penny, left side. Now Mitch McLeish, top of the key, hands off to Penny. 7 seconds left on the shot clock. Penny with a three, and that one is good.
CJ stepping outside. He doesn't shoot too many from behind the arc, but he gets that one to go.
And Penny, that'll make it his 20th point, of 23rd point of the night. Ooh, it's Seth Beckham coming the other way.
With the answer.
Yeah.
21 on the night.
Didn't want the Eagles to leave that one. And that is 95-70 with 2:30 left on the clock as Bronner has it near half court. Eagles just looking to close it out now, taking as much time off the clock as possible. Bronner crossing over, now around the back to his left. Ooh, and it's stolen by Bryce Carlton. Nice hands there. Mountaineers pushing the other way. Oh, and a great around the back pass by Carlton. It'll go out of bounds, though.
Yeah, Carlton there showing some skill. It's hard to steal the ball from Sean Bronner. I mean, yeah. I played pickup with him a little bit. He's got handles.
Bronner,
so Carlton with nice defense there.
Bronner with some great ball handling skills. And checking out for the Eagles, number 33, Dakota Uten, and number 25, C.J. Penny, as well as number 20, Mitch McLeish. And you can hear the fans cheering.
Yeah, giving them a nice ovation with Uten. 10 for 10 from the field, 6 for 6 from behind the arc, 26 points. Penny played extremely well, as did McLeish. So all three of those well-deserving of that applause.
Huff to the line for the front end of the 1-1, and that one's missed. Subs for the Mountaineers as well. Number 3, Ryan Schnellenberger coming back on, as well as two other subs. I believe Garmin and Deion Banks check back on. Oh, my fault.
Bennett.
Lathan Bennett checking back on. And a foul here as Sean Bronner goes inside. And the ref signals a hit to the head.
Got hit on the head there on that shot attempt. So Bronner will head to the line where he has shot 68% on the season.
And the subs for the Eagles coming on for those three big players tonight for them as Sean Bronner misses the first. That is Daquan Gordon, Levon Morris, and Justin Jones checking on. Adam Delph checking off now, and he gets an ovation from the crowd. Kyle Bear comes on for him, and you got to say these players deserve that.
Yeah, and I think with the seniors, this is the next conference game. The tournament game is going to be away, and so this is their last home game.
Yeah, kind of their last hurrah, as it were. 96-70, 1:50 left on the clock. And this game's just about over as Maddox takes a three from long range. That one misses, and Kyle Bear gets it now. Kyle Bear has it, crossing over to his right. Oh, and he's tripped up, goes to the ground, and that'll be called a foul. He'll go to the line for the 1-1. And about to check on for the Eagles is number 30, Todd Jefferson. You've got to figure he would come on for Sean Bronner.
Coming on for Jones.
But Jones instead, and the seniors coming off in order now. Jefferson comes on for Justin Jones, and the crowd gives him an ovation as well. And I must give all of them an ovation myself. Just a great season from these guys, and the last time we'll get to announce for them.
Yeah. Yeah, Jones had a very good four-year career here. It's not over, but just he won't have another game here at the Loose. But all-time leader in blocks for Asbury, having his last home game here.
Bear makes both at the line. That makes it 98-70 with 1:30 left on the clock. Justin Jones, as we mentioned before, over 200 blocks in his career. And just an athletic player, a good kid, and good to see him get an ovation, as well as Delph and Uten and Sean Bronner.
They call a foul there on Sean Bronner.
And that was on Dominique Garmin. That's Bronner's second, 10th of the night for the Eagles. And Garmin will go the line for two here.
So a minute 25 left here. We'll try to get Coach Schaus to come over here and talk after the game, as he has to be pleased with the effort. This is probably the most complete game I've seen out of Asbury all year.
Garmin makes his second at the line. 98-71, 1:25 left on the clock as Kyle Bear brings it across half court. Eagles just look to close this one out, and after this game, the Eagles will move on to face IU East in New Albany, Indiana, and that'll be February 25th at 2 p.m. Unfortunately, we do not get to call it. It's been a great game tonight. Sean Bronner driving inside now. He goes up and in with the layup, and Sean Bronner getting some applause.
And that puts it at 100 points on the night.
The Eagles break triple digits. Coming the other way is Dominique Garmin, and he'll go line after a very athletic layup there and the end one opportunity.
Yeah, Jefferson was there. He thought about taking a charge, the Berea player there, Garmin, just avoided him and made a little bit of contact with him enough to get the foul call as well.
Garmin misses that one, though, and DQ comes up with a rebound, strong rebound from him. He's had a good night on the rebounds as well. That'll be his fifth. Oh, and a tie-up here in the middle of the floor. It'll be a jump ball. It'll be Asbury's ball, though. Kyle Bear, and I did not see who that was. Lathan Bennett and or Dominique Garmin. I'm not sure.
Yeah,
did not see behind the ref.
We got an 18-second differential on the shot and game clock, so Asbury will have to put up a shot.
30 left on the clock now, and 13 on the shot clock. DQ gets it inside to Jefferson. He backs down, now kicks it out to Bear, right side for three, no good. 20 seconds left on the shot clock as the Mountaineers get the rebound. On the game clock, shot clock is off. Schnellenberger misses it. Sean Bronner comes up with the rebound. 14 left now. Oh, and he finds Jefferson streaking down the floor. Jefferson puts it up and in, and he gets 2 points. Good on
you. Gets on the in the stat book.
Good for Jefferson.
I think Jefferson wasn't sure if he should shoot or not because the game's been decided. But.
Jefferson, a freshman. Good to see him get 2 points. And that's the final score, ladies and gentlemen. 102-73. Eagles in what can be said was an easy game for them, almost winning by 30 points. Just a great game.
Yeah, fantastic performance. We're going to talk Coach Schaus here in a minute as the teams are shaking hands. The player of the game, we don't have a sponsor for this or anything, but the player of the game, no question, Dakota Uhm. Perfect from the field.
Just absolutely monstrous night.
He was balling. He was unconscious tonight.
And
6 for 6 from behind the arc, 10 of 10 from the field, 26 points.
And you could hear the crowd go absolutely berserk when he made that last three. And he made three threes in a row as well. Two of them on consecutive possessions in the second half. Just an absolutely crazy series of events for Dakota Uhm. Andy will now go head off and try and get Coach Schaus after the teams huddle up. And always good to see the teams get in the middle of the court and lock arms and pray to up at the end of the game. Whether you agree with praying or not, it's always good to see the teams come together like that. Good camaraderie, good sportsmanship, and a great game for the Eagles tonight, 102-73. I've just got to reiterate that final scoreline. After this, as I mentioned, as the game was coming down to an end, that the Eagles will take on Indiana University East in New Albany, Indiana. That'll be February 25th at 2 p.m. I believe someone will get you that game. And now we're joined by Coach Schaus, head coach of the Asbury Eagles men's basketball team. And Coach Schaus, just a great game to watch tonight. You guys looked like you pushed the tempo early, and you guys got off to that early start. What were the keys coming into the game? I know you've lost to Berea twice early mm-hmm. on. Was that kind of a factor in playing so well tonight?
Well, the big thing was we've had trouble coming back off of losses. And, we lost to Indiana East the other night, disappointing loss. And, getting up and just as soon as I went in the locker room after that, we started working on Berea.
Yeah.
So, we watched a lot of film and stuff. And let me tell you, they dominated us two other times. Mm-hmm. So, really had our work cut out for us. There was a lot of energy in the building tonight. I'll tell you that. The fans were great tonight. They carry these guys. And my big thing was when we get excited, we start throwing up a lot of three-pointers or we forget to guard or we fly around on defense. But I wanted us to use our energy in a positive way, which was on the defensive end. And even though they still scored in the 70s, we felt like we did a good job on the defense.
Yeah, and you guys took a lot of threes, but you made the majority of them.
Yeah.
Dakota Uhm, us. Oh. Just absolutely crazy. 6 for 6 from behind the line.
Yeah, I mean, Dakota's, he gets that look in his eye, and, he wants to have a big impact. And, this time of year, last year, he had a big impact with us, too, as far as, in the tournament. So, hopefully, that carries over. I mean, he had such a big night. 26 and 10 for Dakota. just stepped up and played big. C.J. Penny, 23, 9 rebounds, 7 assists, 1 turnover. I mean, that's a great night.
Yeah. And, Coach, 28 assists on the night. And Delph, I believe, had a double-double and with points and assists. Penny was up there. He maybe had like 8 or 9 assists. And so, you guys were having fun sharing the ball. Mm-hmm. Just a great game, and you seem to come out with a lot of confidence both halves early on.
Yeah, I don't know what, coming out with confidence, hopefully that's something we've done to help that, but I think it's just the guys just saying, hey, it's a refuse-to-lose type of attitude. Delph has been telling these guys, whenever we lose a game, people have been getting down and upset. He said, it doesn't matter, you got to win the last three, and so now it's down to the last two.
That's right. And February 25th, you take on IU East in New Albany. In the semifinals, it'll be a tough game, but
they're all tough here on out.
Yeah, here on out.
So we'll watch tomorrow. The bad thing is we just have one day to prepare, but the good thing is we're kind of riding a hot streak right now, so hopefully they can take us on there. Now we'll have to get some ice and get our legs back ready, but because I didn't play as many people as I usually do tonight, but because I played the guys a lot of minutes, but you do what you got to do in tournament time. So
that's right. Congratulations, Coach. Way to go. Yeah,
thank you. I appreciate it.
And Asbury finishes up the final score, 102-73. Andy, you got any thoughts for us?
I haven't seen all of Asbury's games, but that was just a complete game.
Yeah.
I mean,
came out and defensively not a bad job either.
No.
I mean, Berea averages over 80 points per game, so did well to hold them, but then the offensive end just absolutely ridiculous.
And that's right. And I mean, the guy we were talking about before the game, Ponder.
Austin Ponder.
We held 7 points, 3 of 11 shooting, 1 of 8 from behind the arc. And I mean, he's a statistically great 3-point shooter. He's, I believe, second in the conference in number of threes made as well.
Yeah.
But holding him to 7 points, that's big. And so the defensive end, rebounding, we won by 15. 3-point field goals, shooting 50. We shot 52% from behind the arc. That's crazy. 12 of 23. And just a complete effort, complete team effort there. And it is the last home game of the season, but
yes. That,
you know what? You can't go out, can't leave here on a better note. And, hopefully we're going to continue on. We're going to take on IU East on February 25th, here in a couple of days. And hopefully this momentum will carry over there, and we'll advance to the championship game.
Yeah, and we've had a great time bringing these games to you this season and last season. This is the first season through video, thanks to iHi.com. And for those of you listening on WACW as well, we thank you for that. Unfortunately, this is it for us, for our career.
Yeah, this is it.
This is our senior night as well.
This is our senior night, yep.
We had a great time bringing these games to you, and hopefully these Eagles can go the rest of the way, right, Andy?
That's right. That's right. National tournament, baby.
National tournament or bust. That's what bleed purple. Bleed purple.
Bleed purple.
And the Eagles will continue, as Andy mentioned, and I'm sure as we've mentioned a lot already, but in New Albany, February 25th, 2 p.m., not a lot of time to recover back-to-back games, but we wish them the best, and for the last time. Are you ready?
I'm
it's
ready.
For the last time. For Josh Brown and
Andy Clark,
this has been Asbury Men's Basketball, and we will send it back down to the studio to Daniel Harris.
Daniel, take it away.
And for iHi.com, also our last broadcast, but we look forward to the next game for the Eagles. We hope you'll follow them. I think they'll be broadcast through iHi, through Indiana East.
Go out to AsburyEagles.com. On the left side of the screen, you'll see a live video link. That'll get you to it.
Nice little camera, and that'll wrap it up for us through iHi.com. Again, Andy Clark and Josh Brown. Andy, do you want to say any final farewells?
Go.